What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's me, Mikey Pipes. Thank you so much for tuning in. Right now, we're heading on an emergency service call in North Woodmere, which is South Valley Stream, technically. It's in the southwest corner of Nassau County on Long Island in New York. It's part of the, I guess, the outskirts of the five towns. Customer, new customer, has a Burnham Alpine 150. The screen is blank. He smells something burning from the boiler room, and he's concerned. He wants an emergency service call. So I just left my house. I hopped in my Mercedes Metris service van. This is technically the second service call I'm running with this. I grabbed my tool bag from my other truck, and I grabbed a display. Not that it matters, a display for a Burnham Alpine, because, yep, that's right, ladies and gentlemen. If you call Pipe Doctor Home Services based in Valley Stream, New York, the parts are on the truck in most cases. All right, let's go.
All right. Wow. Beautiful steps here. This is nice. Very, very nice. Oof. Wow. And a compliment door. Perfect.
Hello, hello.
Hi.
You want to come through the garage or not?
Oh, man, I want to. I get to walk down these steps again?
This is a one-in-a-lifetime experience.
This is one of a kind.
Yeah.
Wow.
Be careful, no railing.
No railing, it's all right.
Wow, perfect.
Are you the guy with a million YouTubes?
Not a million, but you know.
You're the one, right?
I'm one of them.
So because my friend, I called my friend, I said, listen, call this company. There's a guy.
Who's your friend?
His name is Svi. I don't know if you heard him.
Svi who?
Svi Rosenshire, I don't know.
Where's he live, around the corner?
He lives somewhere, you know, Cherry Lane or something.
Okay.
He didn't use you yet. He's just,
not yet?
He's a guy that investigates 1 year until he makes a decision. So here's the story. When I opened this, I smelled something burned out here.
Yeah, where's the power switch for this?
This is it.
That kills everything. Okay. So the Sage controller has no power to it. So I'll get my tools. We'll troubleshoot. All right. So one of the first things I'm going to do, there's our transformer right there. The power is off. We're going to disconnect the low voltage side of the transformer. It's the brown and pink, which go to the yellow and blue. And this connection, this Molex connection, we're going to check with a voltmeter for 24 volts. If we don't have any 24 volts there, that means more than likely the transformer is dead, but then we're going to make sure we have incoming voltage to the transformer. Okay, voltmeter, Fluke 116, or any multimeter works. Flip on that switch, please. Okay. We do have action at the system itself. The blower assembly, or the blower, is kicked on. All right, that's the blower that you hear right there, but I am not getting any voltage out of the transformer. None whatsoever. So if I'm not getting any voltage coming into it, we could take our non-contact tester, which someone didn't put back in its place, but we could check for line voltage, 110 volts going into the transformer, which more than likely we have, but we're gonna check that next. And the reason why this board is not getting any power, because the transformer is blown. For whatever unknown reason, we don't know yet. We have to figure that out. It could be a sensor back here. Oh, look what someone did. Someone jumped out the high temperature limit already.
That was a technician maybe 10 years ago.
Or 10 years ago?
7 years ago.
So it's been running without one of the necessary safety switches for... Yes. Let me ask you a question. Let's say...
You came to change...
here's a question. Let's say your carbon monoxide tank was going off in the house. Yeah. Someone decides to bypass it so you don't have to hear a beep anymore.
Yeah.
And that's what happens, you're dead.
Really?
Yes. So this is a safety, right? And it's also measured... It hooks up to a sensor which measures temperature. And it communicates with the boiler, let it know if there's something wrong or not. So it's very important. And someone bypassed this because one day, a long time ago, the part failed. It told you to do something, not you. Or I told the technician to do something, and he did the opposite. But that is an epic failure right there. Next, I slid out the Sage 2 controller and display module. We slid this whole thing out. It's on a little rail there. I disconnected line voltage from the Molex connector. Go into transformer now. Do the honors, please, again. Flip the switch on. Boom. And we have 120 volts. So we've confirmed that the transformer, which is right back there, is dead. We have 120 volts. You turn it back off. You have 120 volts going into it.
Yes.
You have nothing coming out of it.
Got it.
The question is, now, why did the transformer die?
Can be this?
No. Because it's already bypassed. If it wasn't bypassed, I could say maybe. We'll go through the troubleshooting steps.
Yep.
So here's my new transformer. I have the orange and the red because this is a multi. This is 110, 240 volt multi step transformer. 120 volts going in, 24 volts going out, which is technically 28 volts. We're going to disconnect all of our connections first from the Sage 2 controller. Okay, there's that. And go for the other one. All right, everything is disconnected. I'm not worried about the igniter. It's fine. So we'll first turn on power. The fan should come on, and then we'll troubleshoot from there. I am concerned that there was a rag all the way back there. Concerned by this, and we have... I don't have that sensor in my truck. I'll have to go get it. We'll have to come back tomorrow. And we also checked the flue sensor, which is back there. Right there, and that's the new one. And no visible shorts or frays on the wire, so we're good with that. Let's just check that. Yeah, that looks clean as well. All right, so let's turn power on.
Okay.
Boom. Okay, so we have power to the transformer, power to the blower. Now, one by one, we're gonna plug things back in. So let's turn power back off, and we're gonna do this step by step. All right, after disconnecting and reconnecting everything one by one, we got to J8, and we got to this Molex connector, which has my 24 volts coming in and going out to the safety circuit. Disconnecting my safety circuit circuitry there, the high, low temperature limits, and even the stack temperature sensor act there. My pressure switch there as well. Still went out, so I have the new Sage controller right here. Let's plug it in.
And if you take a whiff of this, it smells burnt, smell that.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
This is the, I didn't even know it was made by Honeywell. Interesting. Honeywell's a manufacturer, yeah. I had no idea. I've replaced about a dozen of these over the last 12 years.
Maybe they're using it in other devices. In other.
No. This is only in the Alpine.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. New Sage controller is in. Why he thinks it's 182 degrees when it's not. That's a whole nother topic of conversation. Status. Yeah, there's no way it's that hot. It thinks the supply is 181 degrees, and there's no way these are 180 degrees. Nope. So we have bad temperature sensor there, right? There's a reason why they bypassed that. So there's the active fault. So let's see what happens if we plug that back into there, right, and see what kind of sensor failure we have. Get in there. Okay, active fault. Okay, now it thinks it's 24 degrees. All right, so we've been trying to fire up. This is now the third time it's been firing. What I did was I removed that little jumper that was in the high temperature limit sensor, right? The wiring for it, I removed it. And what's gonna happen is it's not going to, that's not gonna fire up. That's one of the errors. It can also give an error that the condensate trap in the safety circuit is shot. So we're going to put the jumper back in, and then tomorrow we're going to come back, and we're going to see from the schedule, we'll do the full service on this, which it should have. There's a lot going on here that needs to be done on an annual basis, but we don't know the last time it's been doing, so let's put the jumper back in and get this thing going. My jumper is now in. Is it really in? Let's make sure. Yep, sure, she's in there. And it's been out for how many years? How long has that been in that place for?
5-6 years.
That's crazy. So we're gonna drive light off and we're gonna watch this go into ignition. But look, but now we're running.
Yeah.
See that? We're at 100%.
Yeah.
We're logged into manual mode, so we're at 100%. So, and to log into that, we're gonna back out again. We're gonna go to adjust. We're gonna go to contractor. Nope, sorry. We're gonna go to adjust. We're gonna log in. The password is 76. Enter, display is a little off, save, adjust, manual control, and right now we're in manual fire. And if you look through the little sight glass window, there's our flame.
Yeah.
Okay? This is our primary loop with our two closely spaced T's. There's a primary loop circulator. This is the original one that came with the boiler.
No, that's a new one.
No, well, it's the same type.
Yeah, same type. Yeah.
Same model.
Yeah.
Right? And they maintained 1 inch there to 2 inch. No, inch and a half. Inch and a quarter. Wow, I was wrong. Inch and a quarter. One.
Legit?
Yeah, it's legit. Yeah. Flow check.
When I renovated the house.
Very nice.
It was done new, including this one.
You just kept the boiler.
Just kept the boiler and then all the radiant heats. You see right here?
Yeah, I see you. The manifold, the half-inch packs.
Another
thing. Very nice. Cool. It's in post-purge now. Why is it in post-purge? Well, we'll figure that out because the set point's 180 and it's 136. So, just finishing up this service call. Replace the transformer, replace the stage 2 control. And look at this beautiful house, by the way. Absolutely love it. All right, so there we have it. Just finished up this emergency service call. It is a little after 6 o'clock in the evening. Got him up and running. And wow, I love that staircase. Beautiful, beautiful house. I love that modern look. Don't let my wife see it, otherwise she'll make me redo the house again. But one of the things I did off camera that you guys didn't see is that I further strengthened the new relationship that was formed when he called a little before 4 o'clock today that he needed emergency service. So I further strengthened that. You know, I got his email address so I can send him the receipt, and we started talking about his domain and what his domain name of his email address, and he owns a video surveillance company. And listen, you further strengthen the relationship that already I saved the day. You know, we had a major safety that was bypassed and been bypassed for a number of years. But most importantly, we fixed the problem. You know, it's if you're in the service and repair business, you know, the parts, you know, it's hard to have everything, but the common things you work on, you should have those parts in your truck. You know, I didn't have the Sage 2 controller in my truck, but I had it in the shop and I had it in my other truck. So I went and got it. Got the job done. That's what we do, ladies and gentlemen. Get the job done, make people happy. And that's what I really, really enjoy doing. I love fixing things and I love making people happy. I love having a smile on their face. You know, there's an old saying, and this guy said it to me right before I left. He goes, "Thank you so much, Mike. You know what they say, a happy wife, happy life." And I was like, "I got you, bro. I got you." Thank you so much for tuning in. Hope you got something out of this video. I didn't show much of the troubleshooting for that blown transformer, but one by one, I was disconnecting all the controls and the harnesses off the stage controller. And when I got to that J8 connection, that's when we verified that with my voltmeter reading voltage, you know, from the transformer, when I had that plugged in, I had 5.8 volts when it turned on. All the other ones, one by one, I had 28 volts. So it's a process of elimination, sometimes a little time consuming, but do your due diligence and be persistent and you will find the problem and you will excel as a technician. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Let me get your thoughts and feedback down in the comments section down below. These parts, oh my God, ridiculously expensive, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars just to have it in my truck. You know, I don't sell them for, you know, my cost price. You know, we have the thing called markup and guarantee. But parts are just so expensive, it's ridiculous. And half the time you can't even get them. Until next time.